In 2014, the Potsdam Summer School took place for the first time. 40 participants from 26 different countries, embracing all continents, were invited to deal with global challenges and to address urgent questions on how to shape sustainable futures in the Arctic and beyond.
The Arctic in the Anthropocene is the great unknown. We've entered this age where humans have become as though a geological force. We are changing the face of the planet, and no place is changing more than the Arctic.
Under the overarching theme, Arctic in the Anthropocene, this two-week program was jointly organized by four major institutes together with the University of Potsdam and in partnership with the city of Potsdam, capital of Brandenburg. The goal was to bring together early career scientists and young professionals from various backgrounds to foster and enhance international cooperation and the exchange of ideas.
We give knowledge to people from all over the world, to young scientists, to young decision makers.
We've brought together a broad group of experts, people that are working in the academics, but also people that are working in NGOs and various government agencies, to exchange information with each other about the issues that are needed to be understood better in order to drive us towards a more sustainable transformation of the Arctic in the future.
Unexpected discussions are unleashed and new insights arise even for the speakers, not only for the students. The anthropogenic change that is happening on our planet is manifold. Those changes include climate change, but also direct changes on the land surface, on the nature.
Changes currently occurring in the Arctic and Antarctic regions are therefore partly driven by Earth system dynamics and will in reverse have an impact on other subsystems. We want to help participants to understand the complexity of this Earth system and the related processes.
To meet people coming from different fields, sometimes in the same field but you don't realize they're in the same field, and get together in a very open atmosphere where you can just talk freely. And so I hope this becomes a successful event personally for you as it is scientifically.
We really need to change the way we think about the Arctic. The Arctic is both a source of problems and a focus of the global problems in terms of melting sea ice and changing environmental and political conditions. So changing the way people see the Arctic will help us address global problems.
You may delay the melting of part of the snow and ice in the Arctic, in the Himalaya, in the Alps. You may reduce the temperature between half a degree and 1 degree. But if you don't take the action within the window, no, if you do it in 40 years, it's too late.
Also, as a global citizen, as somebody who has had the opportunity to come from a different part of the world and study and work in a whole different part of the world, I would like to understand how do people make decisions, especially in case of the Arctic, where a number of different countries are involved, where a number of different political interests are involved, not only political interests, but scientific interests. So I'm interested in the interconnectedness of the system.
For years now, I think we've identified climate change as a big priority for the Arctic and for the world, for the global community. And moving forward, I think one of the challenges will be to coordinate and concert our efforts and to make sure that we are engaging people beyond the traditional sort of stakeholders that we've had at the table.
High-level knowledge was contributed to the summer school program by a host of experts, stakeholders, and lecturers from the organizing institutes as well as from international organizations.
That there's people living in the Arctic who are severely noticing the changes that are happening today, both climate and the industrial priorities that are happening there. It's directly maybe even endangering a lot of cultures who are dependent on the natural resources like fish or meat and clean air and water, which is basic human rights.
Even in the pouring rain, the Einstein campus is well worth a visit. It is the home to the Alfred Wegener Institute Potsdam the German Research Center for Geosciences, and the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research. In a poster session, the three institutes presented research projects related to the Arctic and had a lively discussion with the summer school participants. Topics like the Arctic climate system, including glaciers, melting sea ice, permafrost, and marine systems, were the focus of the program.
I expect that the sea ice in the Arctic will further retreat, and the volume of the sea ice will also shrink. And what we also have to expect is that economic development will increase a lot. Shipping through the Arctic and also exploitation of natural resources like oil and gas, but also minerals.
Yeah, so why climate change is so important for the Arctic? On the first glance, it's not so high populated area. On the other, there is a good scientific reasons why climate is changing much faster in the Arctic than in other places. But in reality, it is changing even faster than it was expected.
Well, the changes we are seeing now in the Arctic probably don't happen for the first time. It might happen for the first time at that speed. But there have always been changes before. And usually, the past is the key to the present, as we say. Our climate is, to a large extent, made in the Arctic. So the Arctic, first of all, is kind of an early warning system for us. It affects us, even though it might seem far away, because everything that ends up in the atmosphere is well mixed and then affects us at lower latitudes.
This is also to welcome you once more. Please make Potsdam not only a short stop for one summer school. Please be aware, it is a cultural center, it is a scientific center.
During a public event held at the University of Potsdam, the vital role of the Arctic in global climate processes was brought to the attention of the citizens of Potsdam. Four renowned Arctic experts discussed the challenges we are facing in the Arctic, and subsequently the floor was opened to the public audience for debate. In the second week of the summer school, the participants engaged themselves in Arctic governance, planning processes, and international geopolitical concerns.
By contributing to the planning process exercise, I would like to have a better understanding again of how to use tools like ecosystem-based management in the context of implementing measures which will allow for the protection of the Arctic environment.
One of the highlights of the two-week program was an exercise to plan the future of Big Egg Island, a fictitious island located in the Arctic and subarctic.
So we divided everybody into four, call them sectors, governments, large industry, smaller scale stakeholders, and an advisory council that was there to recommend ideas and plans to the government. And within those groups, there were about five different roles for people to play. And they had to get in character right away, play these roles, act out a planning process in about 2.5 days.
I want the students to understand that there is no easy answer. I want the students to understand that in a planning process, all points of view are coming from a real place. They come from a real life, a real home, real families, real ways of earning a living. And that to bring these together, especially in the Anthropocene, when everything is changing, that's not easy.
Summer schools are brilliant, and there aren't enough on the Arctic. It's very, very important to bring people together from different disciplines, from different places, to think about the problems, to talk about the problems from their own perspectives, and then to work together. And some schools build networks as well, yeah? So these people will not go away and forget each other. Hopefully they'll work in the future together as well.
So figuring out the relationship between energy and the environment, I think, is the biggest challenge that we face.
Yeah, my expectations have been exceeded. This group of people in themselves have been an amazing collaborative network that I think as, shall we say, young Arctic leaders, we can take this into our future professional careers. And I think that we've learned so much from all sciences.
So one of the biggest things that I've really taken home from this summer school is that the Arctic is not an independent region. It's not something far away that doesn't affect us down south.
I love the idea of the summer school. I think it's a brilliant idea. I think it has succeeded wonderfully from the very short time that I've seen. And it's a model that I think would be useful not just in Arctic countries or Arctic interested countries such as Germany, which has a long history of polar research, but possibly in countries like China. So I applaud your initiative.